2,000 years after the departure of Jesus the Christ. The prophets are back to teach the real Jews, the 12 tribes of Israel, their true nationality. This is their campaign.
I want to say something to you, because we are here on Dykeman and Post. This is a Dominican community, right? The brother Junior was a little Dominican boy, all right? This happened to all the people, all right? The so-called blacks and Hispanics, all right? A little boy was put to death. This whole place should be shut down. That so-called gang, that Trinitarios, they should be all arrested, all right? Or have your children taken out of it. All right? Have your children removed from that gang mentality. How old are you? You're 18, so you're not much older than that brother that was murdered, who had his throat cut out. All right? We don't want our children. We don't want to lose any more of our children. That's why we're out here teaching them the laws of God, so that this does not happen to them, so that this does not continue in our communities. All right? So we want our children to wake up, come out of that gang mentality. That's for cowards.
That's right.
That's for suckers. All right? There's no honor in that. There's no honor in killing your own people. All right? Give me Proverbs chapter 1 and verse 10. I want to read this to you because you're young just like him. I don't want you to fall into that gang mentality. All right? We want our children to come out of that. There's more to life than that. We're more than that. All right? The Bible calls us kings and priests.
Right.
If we knew that, we would not kill each other.
Right.
We would not join gangs looking for acceptance. We would look at the Bible for our history.
Right.
All right? We would look at Christ and God. All right? The true image of God in Christ that looks like you. You look like Jesus. Do you know that? If you would know that, you would not kill your brother. Little Junior, he looks like Christ. All right? You look like Christ. We are God-like. The Bible calls us gods. If we knew that, if we acted that way, we would not be hating ourselves. Give me that, Proverbs chapter 1 and verse 10. Read.
Proverbs chapter 1, verse 10. My son, if sinners entice thee.
The Bible is talking to our children. You so-called Dominicans, you so-called blacks, all right? The Dominican community is a black community. It's an Israelite community. That's why we're out here teaching our people, all right? Because we don't want our children to die. Read.
My son, if sinners entice thee.
If sinners entice thee. If gangs like the Trinitarios gas you up to join them, what do?
Consent thou not.
Don't allow it. Don't go with that. All right? Say, nah, I'm good. Stay home. Stay with your family. Read the Bible. Learn your history. Read.
If they say, come with us, let us lay wait for blood.
That's what happened on 183rd and Belmont. They said, come with us. Let us lay wait for blood. They wanted to kill a little boy. They wanted vengeance. Misguided vengeance. Read.
Let us look privately for the innocent without cause.
Wasn't Junior innocent? He didn't even touch that girl. He had no part. All right, he was set up. He was only trying to do good. Giving a young girl, he came downstairs to give a little girl $5. The same little girl, right, who's supposed to be a little girl, but she's promiscuous. Why are our 15-year-old children being promiscuous? You're supposed to save yourself for when you're married, but she's out here hoeing, being a thot. That's what they call them now, right? Thots. Having sex on what is it? Snapchat, Instagram, showing your body on the internet. That's there for the whole world to see now. Her life is ruined. Her reputation is ruined. But and now, instead of her defending, telling her brother, no, you know, that's my fault. I shouldn't have been doing that. She laid the blame on someone else, an innocent. Read.
Let us swallow them up alive as the grave.
Let us what?
Let us swallow them up alive as the grave.
That's what they did to little Junior. They swallowed him up alive as the grave. They killed that little boy. They put him to death. He was an innocent. Read it again.
Let us swallow them up alive.
From the beginning.
That's the beginning. Verse 10.
Verse 10. My son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not.
The gangs, the sinners entice thee.
If they say, come with us, let us lay wait for their blood.
If they want you to join the gang, right? If they ask you to join a gang, brother, have more integrity, all right? Now you know who you are according to the Bible. Have more decency. Have more love for your fellow brothers and sisters. Read.
Let us look privately for the innocent without cause.
Because that's all gangs is about. It's hurting other people, robbing other people, seeing what they can take from other people, from people's weak that look just like them. Because they don't go to another community and do that. They go to their own communities, to their own people, and put them to death. Read.
Let us swallow them up alive.
What do they do?
Let us swallow them up alive.
They swallow each other up alive. They kill each other. They kill the young brother that looked just like him. Them same brothers that's in jail now for the murder of Junior, they look just like him. Right. They put one of their own to death.
Right.
Why? Because they don't know the Bible. They don't know who they are according to the scriptures. If they did, they wouldn't have done that. Read.
Let us swallow them up alive as the grave. And ho, and those that go down into the pit, we shall find all precious substance. We shall fill our houses with spoils.
You see that? That's going into robbing and stealing your own people. That's what they do. That's what this gang mentality does. Rob and steal from their own people. For what? All you're doing is destroying your nation. You're destroying your community. All right? Give me Hosea chapter 4 and verse 1. But I'm going to keep touching on the innocent blood. The black on black crime, the Dominican on Dominican crime that we see in our community.
Right.
And nothing is being done about it.
Right.
Everybody forgot. That's it. The kid is buried. Everybody forgot. Everybody is back to business. That's what we see here. Nobody really cares. It's all a front for Instagram, for Snapchat.
Right.
You don't really care. It was so graphic and so evil that you were shocked, but you forgot already that quickly. You don't care about that little boy. Because if you did, you'd be doing something about it. Read.
Hosea chapter 4, verse 1. Hear the word of the Lord, ye children of Israel.
So God is talking to you so-called Dominicans, you so-called black people, Hispanic people, Native Americans. Hear the word of God.
For the Lord has a controversy with the inhabitants of the land.
The Lord has a controversy. He is against you. Why is God against us? Because we refuse to keep his commandments.
Right.
Because we refuse to hearken to his laws.
Right.
Read.
Because there is no truth, no mercy, no knowledge of God.
There's no truth, no mercy. They didn't show that little boy mercy. He ran into the store looking for help. They dragged him out. They didn't see that he was a poor, defenseless boy. They didn't bother to talk to him. Did you do it? Did you have sex with my sister? Was it consensual? No, they didn't bother. They just wanted blood. Blood. That's all our people want to see is acts of violence. You're so programmed. You're so programmed to hate yourself that you don't even see it. You don't even see the trick that's being placed upon you. Read.
Because there is no truth, no mercy, no knowledge of God.
There's no knowledge of God in our communities. That's why we're out here teaching the laws of God. Why? Because there's no knowledge. You don't get it in the churches. You don't get it in the schools. You don't even get it at home. We have to come out here to teach our people. Why? Because there's no knowledge of God. Read.
By swearing and lying and killing.
By swearing. I swear I'm going to kill that boy when I see him. And doing what?
And lying!
And lying! That little girl lied! She lied on Junior to save her reputation.
Right.
She lied! And now what? We have a little boy who's dead. Read.
And killing!
And what?
And killing!
Was it Junior killed? He was killed! lying and killing. That's what happened on 183rd in Belmont. There was lying and killing, and now it's a dead boy. All right? But you so-called Dominicans, you don't care. You're back to business. As long as it don't happen to your children, you don't care.
Right.
All right? There's nothing you're doing about it.
Everyone's comfortable.
Everyone is comfortable in your own lives, in your own world, until it comes to your doors. Then you want action. Then you want God to help you.
Bring it out. Right?
But before that, it's too late. All right? Read.
And stealing and committing adultery. They break out.
They break out in what?
And blood touches blood.
Blood touches blood. You know why it says blood touches blood? Because the same Dominican boy has the same blood from the brothers that put him to death. Blood touches blood. All right? We're all family. We're all the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel.
Right.
But we're not being taught that. So I want to save your life, brother. We want to save everyone, all our brothers and sisters' lives to prevent that from happening. Because when I see you, I see Junior. When I see these Dominican boys walking by, I see Junior. I see the same boys that put them to death, I see them walking by. Why? Because they were misguided. They were lied to. All right? But it's time for our brothers and sisters to wake up from them lies. All right? We are the nation of Israel. If we don't stand up for ourselves, no one else will. Because they'll put them boys, they'll arrest them boys, and that's justice. But the real justice comes when we wake up and we realize who we are and we police our own communities.
Right.
All right? We take care of our own children.
Right.
We prevent our children from joining gangs. That's what we have to do.
That's Three. Right.
Therefore shall the land mourn, and everyone that dwelleth therein shall languish.
You see that? Everyone was mourning and languishing, and it was only for a short time. The only one who's mourning and languishing now is his immediate family. Why? Because that's their son. All right? The only ones who's mourning and languishing are those five boys that's in jail, six boys, all right, and their families. Because they're going to jail, but their families got to stay in the same community. All right? They have to deal with being spoken of in an evil manner. Your son is a murderer. That's what they're going to hear for the rest of their life for 10 years, 15 years. All right? But that all could have been prevented if we knew who we were from the very beginning. You understand, brother? Give me Isaiah chapter 51 and verse 20. Because we talking to our so-called blacks and Hispanics and Native Americans, who they are. To wake up out of that lie, all right, that everyone is equal. If we were equal, we don't see white kids joining gangs and putting their own people to death. You only see that in our communities. Why is that happening? Because we're full of the wrath of God, all right? We're misguided anger. We don't know who to turn it to. We don't know the truth. So it's confusing us. It's all a psychological damage that's happening to our people. Read.
Isaiah chapter 51, verse 20. Thy sons have fainted.
Thy sons have what?
Have fainted.
Our sons have fainted, meaning they lost the knowledge of who they are. Because when you faint, what happens? You pass out, right? When you pass out, there's no thought. There's nothing. Our sons have fainted, meaning spiritually fainted. Read.
Thy sons have fainted. They lie at the head of the streets.
They do what?
They lie at the head of all the streets.
Where do you see the gangs at, brother? Brother Paul, where do you see the gangs hanging out at? Yeah, but where do they mainly hang out? No, in the corners. You see them in the corners, right? In front of the bodega, hanging out, posted up, right? They lie what? This is the Bible telling you. The conditions of our people. This is true life. This is a true book. Our people like to make it look like it's a fairy tale, like it's something old that happened in the past, but this is the present here. Listen, brother, I want you to listen. Read it again from the top.
Thy sons have fainted. They lie at the head of all the streets.
Our sons have fainted, meaning they've lost consciousness of who they are. They lie, meaning they hang out where?
They lie at the head of all the streets.
They hang out at the head. The head of all the streets is the corners. That's the head of the street. That's the head of the street. This is the head of the street. This is the corner. The corner where the so-called gangs hang out. All right? Read.
That's a wild bull in a net.
That gang, the Trinitanos, those are wild bulls. Wild bulls. Angry young men looking for vengeance, looking for blood. Their own blood. All right? Read.
They are full of the fury of the Lord.
They are full of what?
They are full of the fury of the Lord.
They are full of anger. Anger. Why? Because they don't know who they are. They don't know how to direct their energy. strategy. So they turn it on their own people. All right, they rob and steal, they sell drugs to their own people, but they won't go to another community and do that. They do that in their community. Because why? The police don't care about us. The only time they show up is to take the body away or to take the killer away. But they're not there to prevent crime. They just there to earn a check, all right? They don't really care. I'm not saying that all don't care, but the majority of the system is set up so that we destroy ourselves.
Right, right.
All right. The only reason justice was passed out so immediately because the thing was so graphic and so evil, and everybody saw it, that something had to be done.
Right.
You understand? But if it wasn't on video, it would have been swept under the rug. You understand?
That's
so now we have to police our own communities. We have to gather our own people and make sure that doesn't happen again. How does that happen? The boy has a mother and a father, but all you see is the mother. Why do you only see the mother? Where was the father? The father was in another state looking for work, all right? Instead of being at home with his family. Marriage is honorable. Give me that, and you know, Hebrews. The Bible says marriage is honorable, all right? A woman is supposed to be a virgin until the day she is married, until she finds a husband who's suitable for her. Not a 15-year-old promiscuous little girl having sex on video, all right? That should not happen. Read.
Hebrews 13, verse 4. Marriage is honorable in all.
The Bible is saying, God is saying that marriage is honorable. Read.
Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled.
The bed is undefiled. Why? Because sex between a woman, a man and a woman, all right, who's married, is honorable. His marriage is honorable. When a husband and wife come together, that's honorable. But when a little girl and a little boy come together to have promiscuous sex, that's a dishonor. That's a disgrace. That's why her big brother wanted blood, because he knew his little sister was defiled. But at the same time, she's not innocent. She didn't cry out. She didn't cry out, rape these boys, rape me. She was having sex, consensual sex. Give me that in Deuteronomy chapter 23. And verse 22, right? 22?
17.
Yeah. No. This is what the Bible says, all right? Read. This is what the Bible says about consensual sex or rape. Read.
If a damsel that is a virgin be betrothed unto a husband.
You know what betrothed means? Exactly. She's promised to a man in marriage. If a damsel that's a virgin, so she has to be a virgin. That was the law of the land. It was a dishonor for a woman to have sex before marriage, and for a man, all right? But in this society, what do they teach you? Have fun, sow your royal oats, you know, and live life. You only live once, right? That's all a lie. That's all a trick. Read.
And a man find her in the city and lie with her. Then ye shall bring them both out unto the gate of the city.
What do you have to do?
Then ye shall bring them both out unto the gates of the city.
So if a damsel that's betrothed to a husband, right, lie with a man and have sex, they shall be brought out into the city. Not to be killed, but just to find out the matter. Read.
And ye shall stone them with stones that they die.
So when we had rulership, when we kept the laws of God, what would happen?
And ye shall stone them with stones that they die.
They will be put to death.
Right.
Now let's see why they would be put to death. Read the next verse.
Verse 25. But if a man find a betrothed damsel in the field, and a man force her.
He what?
Force her.
If he force her, meaning rape her.
And lie with her. Then the man only that lay with her shall die.
Then the man only that lay with her shall die. All right? Where's the one where it says she cried not?
24.
Then shall ye bring them both unto the gates of the city, and ye shall stone them with stones that they die. The damsel, because she cried not.
Because she what?
Because she cried not.
Did that little girl cry rape? She didn't cry rape. So why was that boy put to death? There was no reason for that boy to be put to death. He wasn't even the right boy. They had the wrong brother. You understand? Give me Sirach chapter 11. You have more on that? Okay.
Because she cried not, being in the city, and the man, because he had humbled his neighbor's wife, so that shall put away evil from among you.
See that? We put away
away evil from among us. When we was in rulership, we put away evil, but we didn't put an innocent person to death. Why? Because we knew the laws. We knew. Examine the matter first. Find out the truth. All right? Give me that. Sirach 11, I think it is. And verse 7.
Sirach chapter 11, verse 7. Blame not before thou hast examined the truth.
What should have those six killers, because now they killers, now their life is over. What should have they done before?
Blame not before thou hast examined the truth.
You see what the Bible is telling us? Blame not. Don't blame that little boy if he's not guilty. Read.
Understand first.
Understand what's going on. Did your sister cry rape? Was she raped or was it consensual? Examine the matter first.
And then rebuke.
And then what?
And then rebuke.
And then correct. If your little sister is being out there promiscuous, it's not the boy's fault. It's your little sister's fault. All right? That little boy didn't have to be put to death. You have to correct your sister. Keep her in the house. Show her how a young girl is supposed to behave. Read.
Answer not before thou hast heard the cause.
Answer not before thou hast heard the cause. All right? What was the cause? This little girl was having sex on Snapchat, all right, with her boyfriend, and she blamed someone else. That's what you do. You find out before you get all crazy, hot-blooded, and hot-tempered, all right, and want vengeance and blood, you find out. Let me see if my sister's lying, all right, because let me see the video. Is that you? Yeah, that's you. Is that the little boy? I'm not sure. Let me find out. Let me go question him. Let me go find out. Not drag the little boy out of his house, out of the store, and stab him up 1,000 times, 100 times. Because now what? Their life is over, just like his life is over. The community is destroyed now. All right? Why? Because they saw a senseless act of violence. All right? And it all could have been prevented if we apply these laws.
Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.